Hi everyone, and welcome back to Toe of the Week. Stay tuned so I can show you how I did the toes that match this set of nails. Good to see you and good to be back in doing a Toe of the Week design for spring. And let's stop and take a look at them. Aren't those beautiful? I just love them. I think they're a little bit more elegant. Having that white French tips with all that greenery, they're more elegant. And I can't wait to show you guys the outfit that matches. I think I have that one and one more for spring, and then we're going into summer looks, so I'm excited to show you guys that. But before we go on, let's go ahead and read our prayers and promises. This one is on fear. This is a great one, you guys, because we are going through a lot of hard times right now, but we have nothing to fear. This one is 2 Timothy 1:7. God gave us his spirit, and his spirit doesn't make us weak or fearful. Instead, the spirit gives us power and love. He helps us control ourselves. And he does. If you ask God to help you, definitely he helps us to control our fears, anxieties, everything. We can cast them all unto him, and he will take them away. The next one is Psalms 27:1. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Who shall I fear? The Lord is my stronghold in my life, and who shall I be afraid? There is no reason to be afraid of anything when you have God. Nothing. Fear not, my child, for I am with you. I'll never leave you nor forsake you. God talks about fear in the Bible 365 times. So yeah, and that's how many days of the week, of the whole year. So we don't have to fear nothing, right? The other one is Psalms 56:3-4. When I am afraid, I will trust you. I praise God for his word. I trust God, so I am not afraid. What can human beings do to me? And they can't do nothing to you when you have Christ. Absolutely nothing. You know, I know things happen in our world, but when we have God, he's right there to protect us, and he will keep us safe always. The other side says, the damage others are able to inflict on me is severely limited because, God, you hold my heart. You are my light, my salvation, and the stronghold of my life. You are my helper, and you equip me with confidence to overcome my fears. I love that. So even if we do have, you know, things in our life that tried to hurt us, God is right there with his salvation to save us. Each and every fear I have, even the most hidden ones, you are aware of and will give me the tendency to face them with power and in love. And that's what God loves to do. He loves to help you, you know, when you're in need, but he will help you, even the hidden ones. He's going to help you overcome them. He knows he's there. He knows everything. He even knows, even when we don't want to talk about it, God knows, and he's there to help us with power and in love. And I love that how he says with power and in love. God loves us so much. Nobody could love you more than God. And then the bottom says, what fears can you give to God right now? What fears I can give to God right now is just this pandemic and the riots, that God will continue to keep me safe. And I know he will. I have to not fear because he tells me not to fear. I have nothing to fear. So I would say that it's what I've been mostly, you know, praying to God for, is this pandemic and not getting the virus, since I do have a heart condition, hoping I don't get it. Well, I know I won't because I have God. And if I do, God's going to get me through it no matter what happens. I have him and I have eternal life, so I don't have to fear nothing. But that and the riots probably would be my biggest fears that I'm going through right now. Other than that, I'm doing great. So, but anyways, I hope all of you guys are staying safe, happy, and healthy, and reading our good book of God, the good word. Read, start your day, go through your day and end your day with Christ. Read scripture, write it down, spend quality time alone with him, and God will always be with you. He's never going to leave you nor forsake you. And in order to make it to the kingdom of God, we got to be best friends with Jesus and know that he died on the cross for our sins, for our salvation. So even though that we are sinful people, our name is written in the good, or written in the book of heaven, and we're going to enter the streets of gold if we are a believer. So, gotta believe, guys. And definitely, you know, read, 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 and pray, pray, pray. so happy to have God in my life, and I'm just happy to be back into church. Been going to church and everything. It's fun. I'm filming on the same day that I did all of my cleaning and my treat video. You got to see my treat video. I've done almost 6 hours of cleaning today, did my treat video and my toe video because my husband has to film early this week. He gets a couple days off. Tuesdays and Wednesdays are his days off, and Wednesday we got storms coming. We got storms coming even on Tuesday, but not till later, so hopefully we miss them and I get them done because he's back on Thursday, and of course I load the video on Friday for Fashion Friday. So yeah, we got to get it done early, so I had to get the toe design done as well. But yeah, everything worked out. That's what keto does to you and what God does to you. Gives you all the energy. I prayed this morning for the armor of God. I always put that on. That's Ephesians 6, 10 through 17. I always put the armor on and ask God to give me the strength to get through this really tough day. I mean, it's not tough. I just mean that I clean every week on a Monday. It's about 3.5 hours of cleaning. But every sixth Monday, which was today, I do even more. And it's like almost 6 hours of cleaning. And I explain that in my treat video. So, and I might even do a video one day on all the cleaning that I do. Maybe I'll wait for the next 6 weeks just to show you everything I do. Because I know my good friend Jennifer, who gave me that book, has been wanting to see that. But I need to get a better camera so I have more space on it and a better tripod so it's taller. Because this is as tall as this one goes. And I'm sitting down. So, but anyways, sorry if I look like crap. The lighting is bad behind me, so hopefully you can see me okay. But anyways, let's get on to this toe design. I hope you guys will enjoy it. I hope you will try it out. Definitely is fun doing leaves and stuff and all this greenery. It's very fun. Or just do one accent toe. It'd be really pretty. So let's get on to it. And when you come to the end, when I do the outtake of the toe design, remember I'm showing three more pairs of shoes from my collection. The third pair will be what I'm wearing in this Fashion Friday. And I can't wait for you to see Fashion Friday. I have one or two more to go, I think, like I said, and then it's summer looks. So I love you guys very much. Let's get started on this design. Everybody take care. God bless. Stay safe. I keep praying for all of you. Keep that faith and strength in God and trust Him. Let's get started. Hey everyone. So here's what I chose to go with for this week's spring toe design, matching the nails I did on Monday. All that beautiful greenery against white French tips and northern lights and rhinestones. If you'd like to see how I did this one, continue watching. Hi everyone, and welcome back to Toe of the Week. Getting ready to do another spring look. And of course it's gonna match those beautiful greenery nails I did on Monday. The French white tips with all the green leaves, the little white flowers, and the rhinestones and the northern lights. We're going to be doing that on the toes. Of course, the toes will look a little bit different. I'm going to do the big toe like these. And the small toes, I'm not really sure yet. I might just add in some rhinestones, maybe just the glitter over it. I'm really not sure. But I've done the baby toes solid, and I did the big toe angled with that French like I did on my Monday's nail video. If you didn't get a chance to see that, definitely check it out. If you don't watch them and just watch the toe video, I'll go over and show you all the supplies I used. All right, so I started this for the French look. I made this. It was just a clear polish from Dollar Tree, and I got the Kiss Pink. It was a very soft baby pink that I bought also. Added 30 drops into it, and then I just mixed it up, and it's like a sheer polish. And I use that to do my French looks. And then, of course, I'm doing the white, and I got that also from Dollar Tree, and it's got the numbers there. It's just white. It's the only white Kiss they have. They have other white polishes, but the one by Kiss, this is the only white one. So you know you'll get the right one. And then I'm going to be using an liner right there. It's Art Deco. Got it from also Dollar Tree. And that's how I'm going to do the little line coming up. That's going to be the vine that I put all the leaves on. And then I'll be using acrylic paints, which I'll be using white, green, and black. Just so I can make this green more of a forest green, and then make it a little bit lighter green, and then even lighter green like I did there to put the highlights in it like that on the thumb. So I'll be doing the acrylic paints. And then to do the leaves, I'll be using Robin's brush, the wand. I talk about that a lot. You order them, robinmosesnailart.com, or go to her YouTube page, and it's linked down below in her box. This one is called the wand. It is her liner, and she has a striper. Keep them dirty in between. Clean them with 100% acetone. I just use it to do it with acrylic paints. And then I'm going to be working with this wheel here, the wheel of color. I'm going to use this emerald green there to be putting the stones on. I'm going to glue them down with ASP glue and using just an orange wood stick, the ASP glue I got from Sally's. I'll be gluing the stones down. Then I'll be going over the top with the Sesh V Dry Fast Top Coat, which I don't have here in the video, but I'll have it in just a moment. And then I'm going to probably, I'm going to be using this too, the Northern Lights. You just shake it up. It's a holographic top coat. I put that on first, and then I put the sesh feet over the top. I've already got the sesh feet on, so when I do the art, if I make a mistake, I can just use 100% alcohol, or I'm sorry, 91% or higher alcohol, but even 50% works. Hard to get to alcohol right now, still because of this pandemic. But yeah, it'll still clean it off, or even some water. We'll clean it off if it's still a little bit wet. But you got to make sure you top coat at the very end, because water will definitely wash off your design. I know I got a little bit of a mistake here. I kind of bumped the side of it, but I'm not worried because I'm going to be putting leaves on and stuff. You won't even notice that once I'm done. So I'm not even going to worry about fixing that. And I think that is everything. So I'm going to get started on the little line that I do to do the vine, and then I will return. Okay, so I've got one with the line on it. That's what I'm talking about. And I'm going to be coming off of it with the leaves. If you didn't see Monday's nail video, I'll be coming off with the leaves on that. So we'll go ahead and draw in. And like I said, I'm just using the Art Deco polish there and the little thin brush. We're just dipping into the polish here. And I'm just going to go to the bottom of the toe here and set it down and just kind of go like this and roll and just come till I come to a point. They don't have to be identical. Like I said, it's just supposed to be kind of a vine because I'm really making these kind of look like, I called my last one vineyard, just like all a ton of greenery because it's so green here in Minnesota. I'm sure in a lot of places it's really green. The spring is really making everything beautiful with all the rain we've had and everything. So, but won't be long and we'll be going into summer looks. I believe it's June 20-something will be summer. I think it's the 20th or, yeah, I'm not sure. But we're coming up to summer here pretty soon. I'll be doing summer looks. But yeah, so there's the little line there. We're going to be now getting some of the leaves going. I'm going to get some of those done and I will return. Okay, so we got the start of it with the darker kind of army green. And I'll show you my palette here. Got the darker green. I added a green and then some black into it. And then I went lighter and lighter, using all in the same family, just adding white into it. And then we'll use pure white at the end to do the little dots of kind of like cherry blossoms, but we're going to be doing them white. Okay, so I'm just drawing in here. I'm going to dip into the darkest green here. And we're just going to go right onto the stem here and make some leaves. Just go to one side and to the other and make a leaf. Do another one up a little higher, and then we'll put one in here as well. I'm just kind of putting them around too, because I really want this one, like I said, just to be a bunch of greenery. Basically just to represent spring and the beauty of all the green. Put one in down here, and one up in here, just a small one. Kind of come off to the side like that. Okay. So there's the start of the green, and then now we're going to go into the lighter green, and then from there I'm going to do the highlight. So I will come back after I've done one. Okay, so see, now you see the lighter green, and then you see the highlights through it. So I'm going to show you how I'm doing that. We're going to the second color in the middle there. I'm going to start with that to do the leaves. Just get a little bit on my brush and just randomly put them through again. Just make more leaves. Just wherever you feel you want to put them. They can go on the white part and everything. Just make sure you give them that little pull at the end so it looks like a leaf. And then we'll get some on the other side here. One over here. Like that. And give it a little pull at the end. So like that. And then I'm going to go right into the lightest white. You really want to wait till they're dry before you do this, but I've got some of the green that is dry, so I'm going to do the darker ones first, just adding in a little highlight into them, just so they pop a little more. Then we'll go into, okay, this one is not giving me a light. All right, then go into the lighter ones and just add in, if it's wet, it's fine. Just real quick do it, add a little bit more paint, and then you can get it in there like that. Now it's got the highlights. I'll back up, and it just makes it look, it stands out a little bit more. You see the leaves a little bit better. So now I'm going to do the little white dots and I will return. Okay, now you see the little white dots on there to be like a cherry blossom, how I did it on this toe here. We're going to be doing it on that toe now, and I'll show you. I just want them to be just like there's a little bit of white flowers kind of coming up the vine. So I'm just getting some white paint, and I'm kind of doing it in a sequence. I go one, two, three dots. And then I go to another spot and do three dots. And then I go to another spot where some of the green would hit it so you could see it like that. And then I'm gonna go up a little higher and get three dots there. And then I'm gonna go down here a little farther into this green and add some there. And I think I'll add a little bit there too. Right here, go one, two, three, like that. And then you just get the idea of like a flower going up. Let's get one right in here too. Just kind of going up the toe like that. Isn't that cute? I really think it's beautiful. So we will finish up here and let me back away here. Can't use that finger because I got a glove on. Okay, now the next step is to put the rhinestones on. So I'm gonna get that going and figure out what I'm gonna do to the baby toes. I might add a little bit of greenery to one of them and then maybe some stones, not sure. I will return. Okay, before I go onto the stones, I did add a little bit of greenery to one of them, so I'll show you that. And draw it in here. And we're just gonna do a little accent toe. I'm doing a little bit of the dark green. Turn it this way so you guys can see. And I'm just gonna set the brush down and add just a couple small little leaves in the dark green. Hopefully you are seeing this. Okay, and then I'm gonna go to the middle green and add just a couple little of that color green. I'll bring this one back that way and then put it right here. And then I'm gonna dip into the lightest green. While it's still wet, I know, I should wait, but I know how to do it. So we're gonna get a little bit of the lightest green and just real quick put a little line through each one, just giving it a highlight like that. Just like that. And it just kind of, you know, brings it out a little bit more so that you can see, you know, it kind of blends then. And then we'll probably be doing some rhinestones or maybe just doing glitter on them. I'm not sure. I really like them white. So let me get some done up the rhinestones. Okay, now I've got the green or the green rhinestones there and some in the baby toe. And on this one, I'll draw in just so you can see it a little bit better. Let's see, I got the stones in there. So I just got to do it on the big toe. Got some glue and a cap here. And I'm just going to randomly dot some glue just around where I feel I want to put a rhinestone. Just around. It'll be fun. You can just randomly put them wherever you want. Hope I'm getting some glue on here. I feel like I'm not. Okay. Just pick up the stones and just set them down. And I think I did some up in here. I'm not sure. I'm gonna put a little bit more glue right there. I want one there. Okay, that looks pretty good. Maybe add one more right there. It seems like it just needs one right there. Like that. There we go, isn't that pretty? Okay, so now all we have left to do is put the Northern Lights over the top and then the Sesh Feet Dry Fast Top Coat, and then I'll return to show all of you guys the end product. You don't really need to see me doing this. This is just, it's a top coat. You just want to shake it up really good. I'm going to show you when you shake it up what it looks like here quick. Just hit it up against your hand. This one's getting a little bit old, so I'll show you what happens when you mix it up. You just want to mix it good. When it starts to get old, it kind of sticks a little bit more, but that's okay. And I added a little bit more glitter into mine. I had a micro glitter to add. So, but that's what it looks like when it's all mixed up. So we're going to add that. It's just a top coat. I'm going to add it over the whole design after everything's dry. And then I'm going to use the Sesh Feet to dry everything up after that. Even though this is a top coat, I still like to have the Sesh Feet over the top to smooth everything even more. And then I'll return to show all of you guys the end product. Okay, I've got them all done with the Northern Lights and with the Sesh Feet, but I just wanted to show you guys. It's been a while since I came in and showed you going over stones and stuff. They're all done, and you see the sparkle on the white toes. Isn't that pretty? I'm just gonna show you real quick the Sesh Feet over the big toe. So it's just clear, Sesh Feet, dry fast top coat. I'm gonna get a nice thick coat of it. It dries fast, so don't worry. And I'm putting it right over the top, right over the stones and everything. And I did this Northern Lights right over the stones, too. You don't have to worry. I'm sorry I'm getting in your way. I know. Just go over the stones like this. Make sure you pull air pockets out and everything. And just get into all the little nooks and crannies and get it on. And the thicker, the better when it goes on. It dries really fast. But, yeah, it's... I went over with the Northern Lights even on the rhinestones. Like, it's such a micro glitter, you can't even tell. But there we go. And then you see the little toes, how they've got the glitter, too. Isn't that pretty? All right. So, just wanted to show you that because I have newcomers all the time, just so they knew exactly what I was talking about, covering it up. So, let these dry up, and I'll be back to show you the end product. Alrighty, everyone. I am all done, and I'll draw in a little bit to show you closer. Look at how beautiful these look. Aren't these precious? I love them. I think they're very elegant and classy. Love white, you know, French tips. Matches the nails perfectly, and I always do the toes a little bit different, but I love white polish, especially in the spring and summer, even winter. I just love white. I think it's very classic, but I love all the greenery. There's so much green going on right now in our world that I wanted this set to be, you know, a lot of green and just a lot of leaves. And, of course, it's going to match an outfit of the day, so I can't wait to show you guys that as well. Now, stay tuned because right after this, I'm going to be showing more of my shoe collection. I'm actually on my third shelf, and altogether I have 7 more shelves to go, plus some shoes on the floor that I wasn't able to put up on a shelf because I didn't have another shelf up for it. And then I also have a shelf with boots, but that I'm going to show you in the wintertime. I'm just going to show the shoes. But yeah, I'm only on the third row right now. I had altogether 10 or 11 racks of shoes. One of them is boots. But again, I'm going to be showing you guys that when winter comes. I'll show you those boots. You guys got to see some of those, though, during my winter fashion. But I'll still show you guys that during the wintertime. Other than that, I hope you guys enjoyed this design. And after the shoe collection, then you'll see the photos. Everybody take care. God bless. And I'll see each and every one of you in my very next upload.